Alright guys, a thought experiment. Let's think about Banker, a project that raised over $100 million last year. Now, a year later, how many people do you think are using their platform with all the money that Banker had for development? Well, the answer is very underwhelming. Only 300 people on a daily basis. 24 hours, how many people are using it? 300. The same with the CryptoKitties nowadays. Only 400 people used it in the last 24 hours. And also, you know, we don't know if it is the same person having 400 different private keys, or is it really the different people that used it? Catalina, what is going on? Are dApps dead? Are we in an apocalypse? Why do we see such depressing, underwhelming, and small numbers?
I think it's part of being a pioneer in terms of technology, because these highs and lows are going to continue happening, and that goes together with the interest of the masses. People come and go all the time, so you have to be aware of when are you launching your product. Don't fall in love with your product that much also, and be aware. For example, if you know that last year we had a $20,000 in Bitcoin, you can expect that a 70-80% correction in the market is going to happen next or very soon, and most of the people are going to be gone because they speculate based on the price, and those are the people who are going to try your product. So something that you have to take into consideration is the interest of people, the stages of the market cycle, and also you were mentioning, Ivan, how good is my product? Maybe the product is amazing, but the people are not gonna be here.
And that is something we talked about before this video, the fact that generally in software development, whether you're building a website, a mobile app, Android, iPhone app, it's so easy to come up with an idea that you think is brilliant. You sit at your home in your basement, at your mother's basement, you think you have a brilliant idea, you're going to be next Mark Zuckerberg.
Yeah.
Then you come out to the world, you show it to people, they don't care. Your idea is worthless. Unfortunately, that is how it works.
Right,
I mean,
yeah.
Most ideas are bad. You need to try it out in the market, you need to do service, you need to actually make sure that what you're building is needed. And something that is very questionable is whether, you know, when you have an ICO, you put all that money in one single idea, whether that idea is even useful or will work out. Will people care? Will people ignore it? And I think it's, you know, just an easy aspect.
And
the idea.
Timing. And the timing. Because maybe it's an amazing product, but it's really bad timing. So, and we're in a very early stages. We need more liquidity. We need more development in terms of technology, and have that in mind. So not only as an investor, it requires minimizing the risk, but also as an entrepreneur, from an entrepreneurial side of view, you need to be very careful and get educated and have mentors and find the best people who have already done this before. And because I know that many people are thinking about doing this, right? Even ourselves, maybe. But something we, as an entrepreneur, we need to think about.
And something else that is very important is that although we have very low numbers, although we have millions and millions of dollars, maybe even wasted in ICOs, I think generally it's a good thing nonetheless. Generally, we are net positive because, as you said, we are in a new market, we are pioneers, and we need to make mistakes. Some mistakes are very costly. We need to have a bunch of bad ideas. We need to waste, and waste in quotation marks, because I don't think it's wasteful at the end. At the end, it's all about trying out, building infrastructure, trying new things, and taking the industry forward. And whenever you have a bubble, the internet bubble or the crypto bubble, it is actually a bit positive as well. Of course, people lose their money, very negative, but something that is very positive is that you give the industry a chance, you give the industry resources.
And that's how we develop technology.
And
it's part of the process.
And that is how internet was developed. You know, in the internet bubble, that is how internet infrastructure actually was laid out. So generally, it is net positive, but of course, very painful for individual investors. And yeah. Catalina, anything else to add?
No, I think something very important to take into consideration if you are planning to be an entrepreneur in this market also, get educated, find mentors, know what you're doing, the timing, and had a really good product. Yeah.
Amazing. So, amazing, guys.
What do you think?
Leave what you think.
Yeah.
I mean, are dApps dead, or is it just the bear market? Is it the fact that the ideas are bad? Let us know what you think about our ideas. Leave a like, subscribe, smash the bell, and I'll see you all very, very soon. Goodbye, guys.
Bye.